Right, thanks everyone for coming along today in the restart of the seminar series. So today Arturo is going to give us a talk on design and implementation of an augmented reality system for visualization of realistic models and autostereoscopic devices. So if we could all give Arturo
a short title.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you for coming. Basically, the purpose of this speech is talk. Just a bit about me and what I do in my research topic. My beginning in the computer world, I started with the study of the computer science career at the University of Oriente in Cuba between 2000 and 2005. In July 2005, I received the Bachelor in Computer Science with a thesis related with Arturki. And this was my introduction with Arturki and the augmented reality world. On September, I gained a position as a lecturer at the Department of Computer Science of the same university, And I've been there during 2005 and 2007. During this time, I collaborate in different projects related with web topics, multimedia, and e-learning. On May 2007, I joined in the PhD program of the Jaume I University, and I visited for first time Spain. During 10 weeks, I participated in some doctoral course, and I decided a research topic. On November 2007, I joined to the Jaume I University as a research associate, and I've been present in some projects related to the management and administration of resource, visualization, and information system. In others, I've been like technological support. In May 2009, I received a PhD scholarship, and I became official member of the Interactive Visualization Center of the Institute of New Image Technology. Well, get it into research topic. My first research was about our toolkit and how improve the visualization process of this system. For those years, 2005, one of the main problems in the augmentation with our toolkit was the virtual object jittering. I found that it was possible the introduction of some filters to reduce it. Unfortunately, this research didn't make any change in our toolkit system. After this, we released a new version, and this problem was solved. After, our interest was focused on how introduce augmented reality technique to improve the learning process in the classroom. A good point as material in the inorganic chemistry classroom. Why? We took this goal as a way to introduce a novel technology because it could be possible to provide new tools to visualize 3D structures with a new technology. The student will increase their 3D capabilities. There are some samples of the model used. In fact, we had a high level of success, and this system was implemented in two versions, the common version of 3D and the stereoscopic version. For us, the next step was increase the realistic appearance. As choice, we took the use of image-based rendering technique as alternative. With this, it's possible to render real and synthetic objects independent of their complexity. It's possible to find a lot of IBR technique, but we focus on the light fields. Why the light fields? The light field bring us the possibility of render complex geometric objects, synthesize not existing image, and interpolate it to ensure correct visualization. Other big reason was the possibility of a light field system provided for another research group of the Polytechnic in Valencia. What are the advantage of IBR technique?
A simple acquisition,
realistic representation, a low rendering complexity, and efficient use of some algorithms, and we can use pre-acquired image from React and synthetic objects. The result of using IBR and Neural Toolkit was an extended version with associated depth information. Here is an sample. Comparing the Stanford Dragon, the BRML version, and the live field version. This point was not enough for us. Why? The live field needs a lot of image. For this reason, the data set is really big. And on the other hand, the capture process depends on the object size. Then, what can I do? For us, a good question. Implement the new capture and reconstruction method to reduce the amount of image, try to test this capture method on real models, and research about the SLAM technique to perform different capture methods. Today, we already have done a virtual capture system on OpenSync Graph. The next step for us is implement a reconstruction method, made several tests to guarantee a correct visualization and use this idea with real objects. Then will be time to make some real capture, do this with a goniometer, a special device that we have in our lab. But with the goniometer, we only can use a small object. The main goal in this topic is make some real capture independent of the object size. That's why the use of the Kinet and the use of the point cloud and the algorithm of point cloud. This is a picture of the goniometer that we have in our lab to make the real capture. About the visualization process, we already have system using the conventional 3D and the stereoscopic 3D. But what about autostereoscopic 3D? The autostereoscopy is a recent technique able to show 3D without any special device by the viewer. With the introduction in our lab of a stereoscopic display, increase our interest in make a visualization system using this kind of device, taking the possibilities. Able to provide binocular depth perception with our special device, a 2D medium display a 3D image providing a stereo parallax view, and each eye see a different image having been calculated to appear from two eyes position. As many recent techniques, at the beginning, are many problems for using. An interesting point is that the current viewing is reached at an optimum point. See the 3D could be difficult depending on the distance and the position of the viewer. The typical problem that we are having on this day is like the inverse image is in the case that the image formed at the each edge is in the wrong way around and blended zone. When seeing both images forming in each eyes, counts a blurred and confusing image. The final goal of my thesis what I want to do?
Create a new life field.
Create new life field models, use them in augmented reality system, and display them on
auto-stereoscopic devices.
Thank you so much.
And this is
the presentation.
All right. Yeah. So does anyone have any questions for Arturo about his research?
Auto-stereoscopic display. What kind of research are you looking
for? We are looking for make models that can be capable to visualize in this kind of display.
Is it straightforward to just render? Is there any difference between auto-stereoscopic?
Yeah. In the particular, in this case, the device that we have 8 views.
The problem right now is that the people that
build the display
don't say us how we can use the full capability of the device. We can guess how to show it. In principle, we must render each view.
8 view.
For each point of view. And right now we are using shaders
to make
the link
between each image.
X, Y, Z.
Yeah.
So I noticed the model you showed was quite pixelated. Is it just
due yes, to but in this case was because of the computer that I use to make the video, the graphic capability are so low.
So it's not to do with the capture, or was it more to do with the reproduction?
The reproduction, not the capture.
What kind of applications are you thinking about your research?
Yes, we think that
the main point of interest in about application could be to the museums. Some people want to show another product in other place, but it's so hard take a cultural piece to another place. Maybe making a real capture of this thing, you can use it in different places, even at the same time.
You mean, is it possible to display this stuff after the reconstruction in a 3D model?
Yeah.
Like as a holographic?
With the displays, of course.
What's the difference? Well, I'm thinking about the experience of this. It's a real difference if you check a picture of the object than if you check a model in all the views. Thinking just in the user, I know that it's
the
technical part. But
for us, the difference is that in this kind of technique, the 3D display is the beginning. But the next step is the holographic devices. It's a way to introduce in this world.
Applications do you see being used for real life situations?
Yeah.
What sort of life things do you think about you can use this for?
Advertisement.
And most of like museum displays.
Mm-hmm. And too many people are thinking that in the future,
if this kind of technique increase, of course,
could be a change of how you're going to see the TV and how you're going to see the cinema. because you're going to see something, but what you're going to see depends on where you're going to be.
And then
the cinema going to be like a theater.
Exactly.
You've mentioned show AR scene with periscope. Camera be the camera that captures.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just fixed in some place that.
This is an interesting
question. Right now, we are using
two configurations of camera. Eight cameras, like a planar configuration,
at the same distance from the target, and
spherical configuration,
but.
The big approach will be when
the use of, in this case, of 8-view, the use of
8 camera,
but
independent position.
There be are you also thinking of using Kinect and
Yeah,
I'm thinking that. But because I think that with the Kinect, because of you can have depth information,
even you can reconstruct the real world.
Yeah.
So I guess the advantage of using an auto stereoscopic display over a head mounted display, for example, is the fact that you have sort of multiple people looking at it. Different angles.
Uh-huh.
So the idea is you sort of have more of a, I guess, a fixed installation sort of thing. So like you said with a museum, you might have the screen will be fixed and that way people can look around. Have you thought about how that sort of influences how you do augmented reality sort of stuff? Because I guess, you know, with your normal HMD, you can sort of move around it and move the card
yeah.
or whatever. But if it's fixed, sort of the screen has sat where it is. Then if you go and move whatever the augmented reality content is on,
uh-huh.
you can't actually see it because you're standing in front of the screen. So you thought about that's sort of like how that will affect it?
No, I don't see how that affected that.
You don't think that'll be a problem?
No.
Fair enough. Anyone have any more questions? Or? All right, otherwise we'll give Arturo another round of applause. He might hang around for a little while if anyone has any other questions. Otherwise, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.